Hi everyone, welcome back to the Ora session. So in last session we have discussed about the basics of Ora as well as the attributes and how we can use that attribute in component as well as in JavaScript. And let's talk about this session. So in this session we are going to explore how we can call an Apex class method into the Ora component. Okay, so in order to that we need to create an Ora component. So I have created one Ora component here, and now I need to create a Apex class. So here few things we need to be make sure that we are using. So let me create first Apex class. So for now let me create a method like public static list of contact, get contacts. Okay, and let me return here simple select id from contact limit 10. Okay, so right now what I'm doing here is I'm creating a method here called get contacts and returning 10 records. But here one thing need to be added, which is Ora enabled. If you want to call anything from the Apex class to the Ora component, in that case we have to enable as Ora enabled. Okay, either we are creating any variable which we want to be explore or accessible into the Ora component, in that case also we need to use the Ora enable. Okay, let me save this one. So let me copy this one. Now let me go here. So in component we know like it's easy like controller only as we are using into the visual for space. Similarly here also we need to include like controller. Okay, now we are in Ora component. So here whenever this component get load, we want to extract data from the Apex class. So what we need, we can do is we can create a doInit method. So in order to create that doInit method, we need to create Ora handler. In Ora handler we need have to give the name as init and value as this, and action can be anything. Like if suppose we have created method like doInit or for example get records, so similarly we can give here. So this method is something which will get called on very initial time when this page get loaded. Let me save. As in previous session I mentioned that whenever we are creating anything logic related things that we need, we have to be mentioned into the helper class. So let me create this helper class here. Let me save. So here we have one syntax basically. So we can see here. So let me copy and paste over there and then let me explain. Okay, so first what need to be done is here we need to get the method from Apex class. Okay, so in Apex class we have created method as get contacts. So let me give here get contacts. Now here is something which do we need to pass any parameter. So right now we don't need to pass anything because we have created the non-parameter method. Okay, now let me come here get contacts. Okay, now here we have action.set callback. So whenever we are calling the Apex class method, that will be asynchronous. Okay, so right now what we are doing here is we are just putting action means this method instance dot set callback means we are just putting a callback. Whenever any callback will return from there, in that case it will come here. So first we need to pass parameter as this. Next will be the function response. So whatever value will get return, that will come into the response. So here we are receiving two major things. One is state, another one is get return value. Get state is something which like you can say success, incomplete and error. Success means our process get successfully executed and we get the value. Another one is incomplete, suppose some network issue or anything, in that case we will receive the incomplete. And the last one is error, if suppose anything get failed in this particular period when we are calling the Apex class, in that case we will receive the error. Okay, now so okay, let me copy and save. And very important thing is this one. So here we can see NQ action. Okay, so basically what it is like, suppose we are calling any apex class method that has to be added into the queue. As I mentioned, it's an asynchronous process, so that's the reason. Okay, now let me save and go here. Let me call, we know if you want to call any helper class method, in that case we have to use prefix as helper dot and the method name. So let me, so right now we just need to pass the parameter. If you want to pass the less parameter, that also can be done. So let me save, go here. Okay, right now I'm not storing anywhere, I'm just calling that method and putting into the alert. Now let me create one application also for now. Let me execute. So C colon and our Aura component name is this one. So let me save, let me preview. Oh, okay. So looks like we are using CMP. So it's because we have given like variable name is component. So here we just need to give the component. Let me save. Now let me go and refresh. So right now we can see we are getting object. Right now we are not able to see the values, but it's returning something. Okay, so in order to see that, what we can do is console.log we can use, and here we can use the comma. Okay, so it will be in readable format. So let me open the inspect element. So inspect element can be opened using the right click and the inspect, either we can press the control shift I. Okay, so right now we can see from server we are receiving 10 records. Right now we can see only receiving the ID. Okay, so why we are receiving the ID? Because we can see here we are only given the this one last. Okay, let me save. So yeah, so we can see ID, first name and last name we are receiving now. So how we can display those value into the you can say to the Aura component. So here we have iterator that in Aura component. Okay, so let me copy the syntax so it will be fast actually. So let me copy the syntax from here. Let me go to the Aura component, enter place. So here we just need to pass the parameter where we are storing the list. So for now let me create an Aura attribute, because we have to store, then only we will be able to use. So view name, so for example context type we want to be a list. So okay, now let me save, go here into the helper class. Let me store component dot set, as we know we have a method v dot. Okay, so we have just stored. Now let me go, so v dot. Okay, so here we can give a variable, means suppose we have 10 contact, in that case one by one the contact will come and store into this one. So for now let me open the use the code, this one dot first name. So let me create the table only. Okay, so let me table t head tr th first name now the last name. Okay, so this should be done here. Let me create here t body. Okay, so here we can give tr. Okay, this should be inside this one, right? So we can iterate the things. T GOTD we can use. So last name we can use, and we can remove this unnecessary things from here. So now we have saved. Let me go here and refresh. So right now we can see we got into the tabular format. Right now it's not coming in the correct format because we haven't added the SLDs. Let me go here. Okay. Let me go here. Class. Saving still. Let me refresh now. Okay, we are using an application. If you remember in last session, I have mentioned that we need to extend the SLDs. So force colon SLDs. Let me go here. So now we can see we are having table into the SLDs format.